Welcome to another edition of Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking. I'm Dean, your host, the Fogcrawler. Today we're coming to you from the homestead again up here in Trinity County, gold mining country. This afternoon we're going to be cooking up a hearty meat lasagna. We start off by browning our meat, our onion, and our garlic. I've drained the meat and now we're going to add the spaghetti sauce and the rest of the spices to the meat mixture. You can expand on the video description below and see the full recipe.
The sauce that you can do can be your own sauce that you've made, or today we're using Prego organic tomato and basil sauce. Each of these is 1 pound, 9 ounces. Oh. Dean's adding 2 tablespoons of sugar.
Tablespoon and a half of oregano. Tablespoon of basil. Two teaspoons of thyme. And a teaspoon of sage. And then we're going to add in some water. We're going to stir this mixture up complete. And we're going to set it aside. Now we're going to put together our cheese mixture. We start off with 3 beaten eggs. We're going to add the cottage cheese. Two little containers of plain yogurt. Very good, John.
Thank you. This happens to be Greek yogurt.
Yep. And a cup of Parmesan cheese. And we're just going to mix this up until it's an even consistency. And then we'll have our meat mixture and our cheese mixture. Then we can start layering our lasagna.
By using cottage cheese and yogurt, you're reducing the amount of fat and cholesterol that you're putting in this dish.
We're going to start building our lasagna layers. What we're going to do first of all is just put a little bit of meat sauce in the bottom of the oven. Just put that down there so our noodles don't stick. Now we're going to take these uncooked, dry lasagna noodles. We're going to lay them down, just overlapping the rippled edges. Now we're going to take the remainder of our meat sauce, and we're going to try to do it in thirds. We're going to put about a third of it in. We're going to even that out. We're going to take about a third of our cream mixture. Spread that out. Now we put a cup of mozzarella down over that, and we'll be ready for our next layer of noodles. Okay, now we put down another layer of meat. Another layer of the cheese mixture. Another layer of noodles.
And Dean has not pre-cooked these noodles. He's going to put them in there and use the moisture that's going to come from the meal itself to cook them through.
And the last layer on top, I'm going to put the cheese mixture down first and the meat sauce on top of that. And now we'll top this off with another cup of mozzarella, a little bit of parmesan cheese, and some aged cheddar. And the cheddar, we're just going to add just enough to give it some color. But this cheddar has been aged for a while and it's really got an awesome flavor. And then the last, not least, we're going to add in some Parmesan cheese on top. This is going to bake for an hour. And after an hour, we'll brown the top for about 20 minutes.
And currently it's about 85 degrees out.
Yeah, out of a fog crawler's element, let me tell you. The lasagna has to bake for an hour. I've got 10 briquettes underneath and one ring on the top. It's about 22 briquettes on top. It's been cooking for an hour. Now we're going to brown the top. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take these remaining coals up here, what's left of them, shove them underneath. I'm going to put two rings of coals on top and it should brown it sufficiently. You want to take a peek at it, see what it looks like? I'm sure it's going to need to be browned. Oh yeah.
Oh, it looks real nice.
Looks good. Yep, we're going to brown that. Okay, we've got the two rings of coals on top. We're going to brown this for about 15 to 20 minutes. We've added two rings of coals on the top to brown it. Let's see how it turned out.
Ooh.
Ooh, that's looking good.
Ah.
Boy, that fills a 14-inch oven right up to the top. We're going to let this sit cool for a few minutes before we cut it. Let it take a set. That looks good. Smells good, too.
Like lasagna should.
We hope you've enjoyed Fogcrawler's Hearty Meat Lasagna. As you can see by the video, it's real easy to make. And boy, is it ever hearty.
In this webisode, we want to continue to show you how fun it is to cook outdoors and what good food can come of it. This is Joni saying happy trails to you.
This is Dean, the Fogcrawler. Stay tuned next time. We're going to be showing off a new toy. This is a waffle dog iron. These were marketed back in the 50s and 60s. You can either pick them up in secondhand stores or you can find them occasionally on eBay. We're going to have fun with this. Remember, it's all about eating good in the great outdoors.
Hey, little hog, he said waffle dogs. That's right up your alley. Until the next webisode, bye.